Hello, my name's Steve Smallman and I'm making this video for Manchester Libraries to celebrate this year's Summer Reading Challenge. The theme this year is Wild World Heroes and we're going to be doing some step-by-step drawings of animals, one in each video. And today's animal is going to be... a snake. So, I think for a start, we'll do two circles. Well, actually, this one's not really a circle. That one's a circle, and this one's more like an oval. Because this is going to be the snake's eyes. And then from the bottom of this one, this eye, I'm going to have a straight line coming out. And it's going to go round. Straight back again, all the way up to here. This is going to be the back end of the snake's smile. Now, I'm going to put above this circle where the eye is, I'm going to put a little bump. And the same above this one. Bump goes back a bit further on this side, if you notice. And then we're going to go around that smile. It's already starting to look a bit like a snake, isn't it? I want him to have his mouth open, so from this corner, I'm going to come down. And then with a nice slight curve on it, and then go back up that way. And then we need to put our lip around that. So it's going to come round like that, quite thin. And then when it gets over here, it gets a little bit wider. A little curve on that as well, because it's going to be a little wrinkly bit there where his neck will bend. Now then, underneath here, well, let's just go back to here. We're going to follow that round and we'll have a curved shape. Now the thing about snakes is they're quite smooth. They're not, there's nothing angular about them, so I want to do smooth shapes. Up and down and up and down and up. Okay, now we need to make the snake's body a bit fatter. So we're going to come into about here and then we're going to follow the line that we've drawn with the back end of the snake. We're going to go around like this and then as we're getting further down the body, it'll get a little bit thicker. Doing this, and then towards the end of the tail, the body starts to get thinner again. So when we go up here, we can get quite thin until we get right to the end. Then we've got a snake. Now snakes don't usually move like this. It's a bit of a cartoony interpretation of a snake, but I think it's quite nice to do it this way. Now snakes tend to have a lighter bit underneath their tummies. Their tummies and the whole snake basically from the neck. We're going to put a line coming down like this. And then it's going to come up down a bit lower. And then over here like this. Over this side, almost to the end, but not quite. Snakes also tend to have like ridges underneath their belly, so we're going to just do some ridges, like curved lines, all the way down the snake's undercarriage. That's one way of putting it, isn't it? See, they're curved lines, which shows you the snake is rounded. So we're going all the way along to the end. When you can't hardly see it, it's not really worth putting it in. The snake is going to be on the ground, so I'm going to put just a suggestion. A bit of shadow underneath his body. So you can imagine we've got some little stones down here as well, if you want, some little rocks that he's just working his way around. Just so it looks as though he's going across some like stony ground. We need to do a bit of work on his face now, don't we? Now snakes have quite prominent nostrils, so I'm going to do one there and one there. You can put a little ridge around the top of that if you want. And then, like we've done these lines on the underside of the snake, down the side of his mouth, we could do some more little curved lines like this. Along there. Now, snakes have that forked tongue, don't they? So if we have a tongue coming from the back of his mouth over here, all the way over here, and then bend it downwards, it's a bit thicker at the back and thinner at the front. And then when it gets to the end, you can stick one bit going that way and one bit going that way. A little forked tongue. The other thing they have is quite scarily sharp and long teeth. I'm going to put a little line in the middle of its nose like that. And then we're going to have one big tooth there and one big tooth there. Snakes do have to be very careful not to bite their tongues. I'm going to just do a little line just in there. I think it's actually quite nice if you have a darker area around the snake's eyes. It makes them stand out more. But I want this snake to look a little bit sneaky, so I'm going to give him, before I draw anything else with the eyes, I'm going to give him some sneaky, snaky eyebrows. They're going to come down right across the eyes like that. I'm going to put some little lines under the eyes like this. I might actually just do a little darker bit all the way around like that. And then we can put a bit of darker bit on those eyelids there. And we'll have them looking sideways. And I've done his eye, his pupil, like a sort of bean shape really. It's not a circle, they have quite slitty eyes, but I've left a little white bit there that I haven't coloured in, and that helps to make his eye look shiny. Same on that side. Ooh, I'm just going to strengthen this line a little bit here. It's always nice to go back, and when you know where your lines are, you can strengthen them. And by doing this look, I'm just emphasising the shape those ridges. You can do the same under here. You don't need to get too carried away. It's just, it's almost like doing a little bump in between each of the lines, and it just makes the ridges look a little bit more ridgy. Stop me if I'm getting too technical. And then of course we can have a pattern on the snake. We can have some wiggly shapes like this, maybe some spots. Yeah, that looks quite snaky, doesn't it? But I mean, it's entirely up to you what pattern you want to have on your snake. Sometimes it's nice to give them a sort of quite random pattern. I'm going to do another little bit, black bit around his eye like that. I need to do the inside of his mouth a bit darker. So we could probably colour that little bit in at the back there, a little bit over his tongue and a little bit under, so we can see where his tongue's coming out. I'm just going to smudge that a bit. The thing is, when you're using a soft pencil, you can use your finger just to smudge it, to put a little bit of shading on. I'm putting the shading on the underside here, a little bit at the front, and a little bit under his mouth, and a little bit on the eye like that. Yeah. It just softens everything up, and it just makes it look a little bit more realistic, doesn't it? I think we could probably these patterns. But if you want to leave yours that, and you can use color rather than shading to do yours if you want to. I'm trying to do this quickly, so if my colouring is not as good as it perhaps should be, then at least you get the idea. And to make the snake move, we can make some little movement lines like this behind him. Looks as though he's wiggling off in that direction. Okay, I think we're nearly there with our snake. One of the things I'm just going to do, I think, actually I'm going to strengthen those eyebrows even more because I want my snake to look a little bit evil. Oh yes, and I think I'm going to use my rubber and just take out that top line where I did the circles to start with, because we kind of don't need them anymore, do we? Oh, and that makes him look even more evil. I'm not one of those people who thinks all snakes are evil, but I don't like to be too close to them, to be fair, so I'm just tidying up his tongue a little bit because it was just getting a little bit fuzzy there. So I'm just going to go back and put in a stronger line. That's better, isn't it? Oh yes. And there we have our snake in the grass. Except I haven't drawn the grass, I've just drawn some rocks. Anyway, that's my snake.